Dear student of standard 10, Assalamu alaikum everyone. How are you? Hope you are fine by the grace of Allah. Today, I will discuss chapter 9, lecture 2. So, today's topic is the role or function of the United Nations in Bangladesh. All the missions of the United Nations organs are in Bangladesh. Bangladesh being the 136th member state of the United Nations always attains special attention from the United Nations. In 1974, the father of the national Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman delivered speech in Bengali and drew in the solemn attention of the international community. All the United Nations associate organizations from its inception have been working in Bangladesh for changing the socio-economic condition of Bangladesh in due course. By this time, four secretary generals at different times visited Bangladesh. Although Bangladesh's contribution to the United Nations is not much so far, but Bangladeshi troops play an effective role on conducting peacekeeping missions by laying down their lives instead. Besides, after being a member state of the United Nations, Bangladesh has been playing an important role towards this international organization. In 1979 to 1980, Bangladesh played a great role as a transient member of the Security Council of United Nations. Here, transient means temporary. Since 1984, the use of Bangla in modus operandi of the United Nations has been a glory for our nation. In 1986, the then Foreign Minister of Bangladesh, Mr. Humayun Rashid Chowdhury, presided over the 41st session of the United Nations General Assembly. This is the picture of Humayun Rashid Chowdhury and his election as the president of the session reminded the international community of the roles specially played by Bangladesh. The country has been successful in resolving the disputes regarding the distribution of the water of the Gangas and the issues of the hill tracts of Chittagong with India by following the rules of the United Nations about the peaceful settlement of long-term problems. Now, the associate organizations of the United Nations serving in Bangladesh are as follows. So, there are many organizations, associate organization of United Nations, at first UNDP, that means the United Nations Development Program. Okay, this is the logo of UNDP. The UNDP embarked on its journey in Bangladesh on 31st July 1972. Since its inception, the UNDP has been conducting various kinds of socio-economic development activities in Bangladesh. The UNDP has fixed 8 projects under the Millennium Development Goals in Bangladesh by 2015. Currently, the UNDP is working on 17 projects in achieving sustainable development goals in Bangladesh. Now, UNICEF. Full form, the United Nations International Children's Education Funds. And UNICEF is a special organization of the United Nations. It serves the children of different countries of the world, particularly the developing countries of the world. It works with a view to developing maternal and child health, nutrition and prevention of diseases, primary health care, primary education and sanitation and women development. UNICEF was established in 1946 with a view to providing relief to the children affected during the Second World War. After 1950, it works for the welfare and development of the children of the least developed and developing countries of the world. The headquarters of UNICEF is situated in New York of the United States of America, and UNICEF won Nobel Prize for Peace in 1965. UNICEF established on its office in Dhaka in 1951, but it started working regularly for the development of women and children from 1977. Now, UNESCO, that means the United Nations Education Science Cultural Organization. This is the logo of UNESCO. UNESCO has been working for development of the education, science and culture in Bangladesh. And this is a social organization of the United Nations. It was established in 1946 and its head office is in Paris, the capital city of France. Presently, 195 countries are its members. The main objective of UNESCO are to ensure peace and security for the world through increasing cooperation in the fields of education, science, culture, and communications. UNESCO has been working with a view to arousing respect for justice, rules of law, and human rights. And Bangladesh joined UNESCO on 27th October 1972. The government of Bangladesh formed the UNESCO Commission in 1973. This organization helps UNESCO to implement their activities in Bangladesh. UNESCO has significant roles in eliminating illiteracy. The organization has special interest in adult education, science education, communication development, and preserving cultural heritage. And 21st February, our Language Mother Day has been acknowledged as International Mother Language Day, owing to the support of UNESCO. Besides, UNESCO has extended their help to preserve heritages of the Sundarbans and other as well as such as the 60 Domes Mosque, Shatgoms Masjid in Bagerhat and Paharpur Buddha Bihar in Nauga. Now, FAO, that is the Food and Agriculture Organization. This is the logo of FAO. The FAO of the United Nations has been working in Bangladesh in order to ensure the food safety for the huge population of this country. And it came into existence in 1945. Now it has 194 member states. Its headquarters is in Rome, the capital city of Italy. The organization has been fighting against poverty around the world. The main objectives of FAO are to ensure food security, agriculture production, and standard life of people by abolishing hunger and malnutrition. Bangladesh is a member of FAO. It has a branch in Dhaka. FAO has dominant roles in the development of food and agriculture in Bangladesh. Our country is not self-sufficient in food. On the top of that, due to natural disaster, often our crops are damaged, resulting in food crisis. FAO supplies essential guidelines to the government to come out of this problem. Apart from this, FAO extends support in food supply, agriculture development, and emergency situation management. And At the same time, the organization extends technical supports for small and peripheral farmers who are victims of natural disaster. Now, WHO, the World Health Organization. The WHO has been conducting different programs in Bangladesh such as supplying medicine and conducting immunization programs for the children. It is working to prevent from 6 killer diseases of the children like polio, tuberculosis, measles, whooping cough, diphtheria, tetanus. Now, UNHCR, that is the United Nations High Commission for Refugees. The UNHCR is mediating on the Rohingya issue between Bangladesh and Myanmar. They contribute to the expenses of running the refugee camps. Besides, this office plays a vital role on different issues, including the housing for the stranded Biharis in Bangladesh. Now, who are called Bihari? The term Biharis refers to the approximately 300,000 non-Bengali citizens of the former East Pakistan who remain stranded in camps in Bangladesh, and out of them many others have assimilated into the Bengali population. Now, UNIFEM. The full form of UNIFEM is the United Nations Development Fund for Women. It observes different kinds of programs for the development of women in Bangladesh. They involve them in realizing the demands of women and in the financial activities of them. It also acts in different issues including safe labor and immigration for the women here. Now, UNFPA. Full form, the United Nations Fund for Population Activities. UNFPA was founded in 1969. Its headquarters is in New York, and more than 140 countries around the world are its members. UNFPA runs its activities through its regional offices in the different parts of the world. The main objective of the organization is to supply necessary consultation and assistance for resolving population problems in the developing countries. It helps the developing countries adopt population policy and implement them by providing population information. Bangladesh is an overpopulated country, we know all, isn't it? So this overpopulation is a big problem for the country. UNFPA is helping Bangladesh to solve this problem for a long time. It also gives advice and cooperation to Bangladesh to expedite family planning program and women empowerment. With the cooperation of this organization, a new department named Population Science has been introduced in Dhaka University. This department teaches many issues on population at home and abroad and runs research programs on related matters. So, up to this everyone, you will read properly the associated organization here. Okay, thank you. Goodbye, everyone.